Greetings, family. Greetings to every one of us. Hope we are doing great. Together, be the sons and the daughters of Abba Yehovah's eternal kingdom. Let us just, bless his name for bringing us together such a wonderful day as today, to discuss once again his eternal blessed mind. Can we do that now, family? Discussing Abba Yehovah's blessed mind, that means eternal food in our spirit. It is our spiritual food. Eternal food. Together, let's bless his name, family. Let's do it. Yes, Abba Yehovah, we just bless you. We lift you higher. We magnify you. We recognize your finger. We know you alone, eternally worthy to be praised and give all glory unto. Hallelujah, Abba. We worship at your feet. We bless your eternal blessed faith that brought us eternal good news of salvation. Thank you, Abba, for doing this great offer unto us, for doing this great job for us, your sons and your daughters. Hallelujah. Yes, you said we are the reason you leave your throne being called merciful, compassionate Father. I love you, Abba. We just love you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, now, family. Here we are in the heavenly courtroom of Abba Yehovah with this powerful message titled for you and me. Snake Iyore God gave Iyore a message of hell. And second Adam gave his wife a message of life. We're going to be rushing it all through. I want to do it fast, not part two. Like I always love to say that when I start doing live video, I'm returning back to all this segment. So today, I want to just talk on it or touch on it very briefly, okay? It is two subjects. I want to talk on it briefly and want to brief it in another ways. All right, now this is the very message you keep hearing me say. I think more than 3 months now, I keep saying it. I'm going to do it. But as you can see, always occupied with different topic, Abba Yehovah want us to discuss, what are we doing in this platform? We are just doing expose the wicked spirit hiding on the people to be deceiving our people, the very one Yahushua died for. No, the power of the cross can never be in vain. The blood shed right on the cross can never be unveiled. Because he said they overcame him, the dragon, by the blood. So that is the blood of salvation we are propagating over here. Okay, overcoming Yore by the precious blood of Yehovah. Yes, in Yehovah's mighty name. Because that woman carried very wicked spirit. Like I always love to say, it's not by sensation, not by radiation, but not emotional, not personal at all. But by the royal law's objective, we want to do this expose once again. Outside Bible, I don't have anything against this woman. Assuming she just come and I begin to, do our babalawo things, who cares? But including our Bible, deceiving our people, no, that one hurts my stomach, making, the effort of salvation of the cross bloodshed in vain. No, we're not going to tolerate that, okay? So, prior to this segment, let us begin to feed in now our spirit with the word of Abba Yehovah. A double-edged sword in my hands. Hosea 4:6, Abba Yehovah said, my people are destroyed, for lack of knowledge. You see, it didn't say the people of the devil. It didn't say the people of Satan. It didn't say the people of witches or wizards. No. Rather, what did it say? My own people. How can you be believing a prostitute? Iyore has to marry, legally married to a white man, having a side chick called Eric. How can you be believing? No, she's condemned. That is why I said my people are destroyed. Because if you really go through the eyes of the royal law, you won't even build your salvation, your eternal state upon a cheap common prostitute, Iyore. No, you won't even be doing a thing like that. Illiterate? Oh no, what does she know? What does she know? Abba Yehovah don't work that way. Abba Yehovah definitely is working with, illiterate, but he will first of all taught them. That will be first of all taught. He will first of all educate them. Like Kiefer, he will first of all educate us, fill us with his word, give us the power of his knowledge, the knowledge of his word, in order for us to speak boldly. Not this illiteration. Now, that, you know, really surprises me to see many people sitting under that, you know, Jagbo woman's voice. I can't even believe that. Oh, like I said, it's not by emotional. Let us put in now, or rather, let us preset in the word of Abba Yehoah. You know, there are some of my video when I just started, you know, when someone, Brother Sarah, caught my attention to this very satanic, demonic woman. There are some video, and I say, in fact, I keep repeating it, and I want to state it here again. It is me and Yuri, okay? Like I said, it is me and that woman. Our case is going to be so severe because you are deceiving people. You are making fool of the cross. You are making fool of the blood that is shed right on the cross. You said that it's not through dead people, through salt and water, through common prostitute. Now, where they propagate you, and they also propagate me, because I'm going to be disgracing you. Until I see you enter the grave, I will not let you go. Because you have done a very wicked thing. Your sin is the sins of blasphemy, unpardonable sin. That's what you carry in your head. On your head, excuse me. You carry the sins of eternal damnation on your head. Therefore, it is me and you. You are from Edo. I'm from Edo. You are from Eukoryon. I'm from Eukoryon. You're precisely from Ewega. I'm from Ewesi. So, Maori of it, we will deal with each other. Father, I'm the one to beat you mercilessly. You wait for me. Now I want to see, through the eyes of the royal law, the part of a woman, how powerful Abba Yehoah made woman to stand before man. Without woman, Abba Yehoah can't, you know, even bring to pass what he ordained or what he desired for himself. He can't. He wouldn't have if there wasn't a woman, okay, in like manner, same paint, the very God of Yuri. Woman, that is our, you know, divinity. That is the power Abba Yehoah bestowed in our womb to be a helper. That is the very name he gave unto us, a helper unto the man, in order for the man to prosper. All right now, Bereshit, best known as Genesis chapter 2, verses 18. Listen, Yehovah Elohim said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate for him. Did you get that? So this is our name, to help a man, to stand by man, you know, to strengthen the man's kingdom. Man. This is what we came to do. This is the reason. In fact, this is our original office given unto us by Yehovah. Okay? So let's put some more. Without us, the man can flourish. Without us, the man can prosper. Like also, these two deities. Without the ministry, Yehovah can function. No. And without the ministry of the devil, devil can also function. You know, ministry is being called a woman, being likened unto a woman. So let's see. We see now the divinity of Yehovah in the woman, a helper to help to stand the kingdom. In like manner, we as a ministry, we help to stand up in Yehovah's kingdom. As we is helping our husband to stand his kingdom, in like manner, the ministry is helping Abba Yehoah to stand his kingdom, to bring to pass his kingdom. And in like manner, the same with, you know, this evil spirit, the God of Yore, the very serpent, the snake my soul hate. Listen, 1 Corinthians, now we have seen who is a woman in the nutshell, a helper. That is Abba Yehoah divinity in our womb. All right, so I want to see, what is death? The message of hell, Yuri, is propagated unto you, helping a fallen deity that is called Ogu. 1 Corinthians 15, 26. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is called what? Death. So what is enemy? Ogu. Death. I think this message is going direct to the Edos. Okay. So death is our enemy. So when do we became enemy? Let's return back there. All right, now for a better understanding, before we go back there, let's see the claims of the biblical Messiah, the very bride I am, the very bride of Yahushua. That is the one talking over here. Let me make it plain. When the second Adam raised from the grave, he saw the woman first, and he now gave her this ministry of resurrection. Go and tell my brother that I'm raising. That's how she became his helper. He helped to propagate the message of a resurrection. The very one I'm speaking unto you. Now, the first, or rather the folly date is the serpent, okay? The very enemy that is being called death, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, his name is death. The day you touch, you shall surely die. That is it. When you touch, you die. Because he is called death. He's our enemy. Don't go there. Now, where this message of death is about also propagate, ushers in into the kingdom of Yahweh, who also had the fallen seraphims. It is the woman, the first woman, the very one Israel is, you know, representing. Because the first woman brought in the message of death, while the second woman brought in the message of resurrection. I've seen the risen king. Now, the first woman saw serpent, and serpent gave her a message. And who did she give it unto? To the body of Yahweh, the first Adam. And that brings about this calamity you and all is going through today. Now, what is death? We see when someone dies, everybody's cry. Why we cry, both believer and unbeliever? We all do cry when someone dies. Yeah, that is the nature inside of us that we never meant to be this way. We shouldn't have been dying. Something came to rob us of this glory. You see the unbeliever cry. We also see the believer cry. We are all crying because our spirit knows this is not what Abewa begins with. Okay? Wicked spirit ushers this in. That is why he's your enemy. He's your enemy. And he's also the last enemy to be destroyed. So let's see. That is the. You're a, dead people sent her message. Don't deny that, okay? All right now, for a better understanding, Revelation chapter 1, verses 18. I read, I am he that liveth. How should I take it from 17? And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead. And he laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was what dead. And behold, I'm alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys of hell and of death. Yes, that is why he holds what they did in Genesis 3. He holds it against them and their children, their posterity. He holds it against them. So because that is the message your father brought, death and hell. So I hold that key against them. Kiss me authority, power to throw you all into the second death, the lake of fire. Now you see, I was once dead. He didn't ever make such claim, I was once dead. He didn't ever make such claims, I was once dead. A mortal never made such claim, I was once dead. We don't have it in history, whether Edo history or English history, we never have it. You never even propagate that when Idia died, she raised back to life after the third day, or a mortal, or Eden. No. So they are dead, they are gone, eternal, they remain in their grave, eternal. Only the biblical Messiah, you know, make such claim and said, I was once dead, now I'm alive forevermore. My enemy, which is the death, I hold the key, that is the power, the authority, to lock him up and his children in the eternal lake of fire. Where do we have such claim that Idia died and rest for you? That is the same Idia you are initiating people to? A mutant, Eden? Where do you get that testimony? That you are not leading people unto death? You know, cast a spear through these dead people. Talking to dead people. Having fellowship with wicked spirit dead people. All right now, Proverbs, we still have a long way to go. I wanted to run to Genesis 3. No, that would be the one to consummate it up. Now, Proverbs 18, verses 21, I read, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruits thereof. Now, I'm propagating the message of life, the very one Yahushua placed in my bosom, in my womb. That's what I'm pouring out. Now, Israel is talking about dead people. And he said, life and death is in the power of what tongues. And who sent Iyore a message? It is dead people. And the very one she is declaring, that is in her tongues. She is calling their name. She's praying through them. She's talking all kinds of, spirituality in their names. All right? Now that she is declaring dead people, which is the authority in her tongues, fearful, say you're going to be eating, if you love it, you're going to be eating the fruit of death eternal, which is the very enemy of the kingdom of Yahuwah. The very one you're is propagating. All right, let's take some more. If you love that death message, anyone that prophet, that, you know, that speak the message of life, say, because life and death, we carry it in our tongue. It makes our authority what we speak. Or who we represent. Or who we speak for. Or who gave us a message, the very one we are declaring, as you, the fully dead or deity or death or power gave you message, as you declare in that death power authority, which it is, or fearful if you love that message of death people. So you're going to be eating of his fruit. Now that I'm declaring message of life, because I saw the risen king in John chapter 20, he said, go and tell my brethren that I'm risen. She knows about the ascension. I'm going unto your father and to my father and unto your Elohim and to my Elohim. Go therefore and tell my brethren. She knows about the secret ascension and the returning back of Yahushua HaMashiach. He gave her the message of resurrection, which is eternal life. The very one I'm passing out unto you. If you love it, you will love life eternal. You will rule and reign in the kingdom of Yahuwah. Not this bottomless pit people. This is it. In one video, I screenshot this. A black guy and the white. This is the one legally married to the white man. This is your original prophetess. May not conceal my original pastor. Pastor of black and white penis. You see? This is a white penis and this is black penis. You are doomed, eternal. This woman. What I'm going to do to this woman? What I'm going to do to this woman? If Yahuwah raised me from my feet. If Yahuwah put me on my feet and set me on top of that high mountain that he said, that, you know, it's all eyes needs to see you. That is the believer. He said a house built on top of the mountain must be seen by all. If you put me there because we are the Bahit, we are the house of Abba Yehuah. If he, in fact, he already be praying for you not to put me there. If Abba Yehuah there, put me there. What I'm going to do to this woman is going to be in breaking news. You claimed worship. You claimed forgiveness. You claimed a praise and service. Yeah, gawe sota. Yeah, gawe. You know we claim that? She's pronouncing forgiveness. What? She claimed worship and service, praise, exaltation. You claiming that? Ah no. Igboloko no wena. Oh, so well for eternity. I'm not better no one like that, man. This is heavy. All right now. Proverbs, like I said, not by sense, not by feelings, excuse me. Proverbs 40 verses 1. Listen. Every wise woman buildeth her house, but the foolish one plucketh it down with her own hands. So, wise woman, Maria Magdala, the very one I represent, was a wise woman. She carried a message of resurrection. The first woman, Kawa or Shawa, was a foolish woman. She used her own hand to destroy her kingdom. The very one this imbecile is representing. Let's go in there. Where are all Iyore moguls, Mumu people? Only the 8% are honored. And we talk for their sake. Not the 92% that needs to be destroyed with this Komochi prostitute. This one is too open now. No. Anyway. Perish it, best known as Genesis chapter 3, verses 1. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which Yahuwah Elohim had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, and Yahuwah said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden. Let me tell you, the garden is the center of the world, because this tree of the knowledge of good and evil is seated in the center of the whole world. It's over here. too. Any woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst, did you get that? Of the garden, Yahuwah has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. So what is that tree? Woo, death, the very last enemy to be destroyed. Now, what is serpent? This is the god of Yoruke. What is serpent in the Hebrew language? So, can we first, quickly, let me put this. Goes to Isaiah chapter 6. They are the highest order of angel. They are the high ranking, the highest of it all. They are the one that's still in the seventh heaven. And they are the banner. They are the one that banner over Yahuwah. In another word, they are Yahuwah's covering. Yahuwah is Yahushua's covering. Okay, Yahushua is the covering of the man, and the man is the covering of the woman, as stated in the 1 Corinthians 11, verses 3. That is the chains of order. But this angel, they're being called seraphims. Okay, go to Isaiah chapters. You're going to find them over there. Seraphims. Now, what is seraphims in the holy language? It simply means the fiery ones. And that is the true essence of Abba Yahuwah, is fire. When is want to talk about Abba Yahuwah's true essence, is the fire. You can see that in Ezekiel chapter 1, 26 to 27, or rather 25 to 26. You're going to find it over there. It's ablaze all from head to toe. That is Abba Yahuwah through essence. Now, in plural, it's called seraphim. Simply mean the fiery ones. Now, singular, it's called seraph. So what's the meaning of that? Flying serpent. It simply means snake, serpent, flies, serpent. But these are the falling ones. That is why they are rolling on the floor. They will crawl. That is the punishment they got from deceiving the woman to help them. So, that is the God of fear. That is called death. Like I said, I don't want to do two. I just want to brush it over. I put it down. I'm coming for Euro. My way, my soul. Oh, we're meeting. We are begging the thing. Y'all pretty. Yeah, you will see what is power. You get power. All right, now quarry now. What? Listen. Now the serpent succeed in deceiving the woman. Why? Because woman is a helper. That was why he did. He goes to the man. He comes to the woman. What did he give unto the woman? The message of death. And as soon as the woman ate it, you know, it's spiritual food, like I said. She now pass it on to her husband. The first Adam got killed and crushed by the message the woman brought unto him. While the second Adam got, you know, praised, glorified, elevated, exalted through the help of the woman by the message the woman helped him to propagate. She went to the brethren. Our Adonai is risen. I saw the risen king. So, the very one representing, and Yoruke is the foolish woman, the foolish foolish first woman. Use her hand. This is how she used her hand. She should have been called Queen of Queens, because Adam should have been called King of Kings. But the foolish woman used her hand to destroy them, their kingdom, and they got banished. Can we quickly read the Abba Yahuwah chase them out? This is how Abba Yahuwah is going to chase Yoruke out of this madness. Listen, 24, that's in Genesis 3:24. So he drove out the man, and he placed at the east of the Garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life. What I'm speaking unto you, life and death is in the power of tongue. I'm speaking life and the power of resurrection. That is where the salvation lies, in the blood of Yahushua HaMashiach. The job of the cross, not sorrow and water, not through the picture of Idia, dead Idia, satanic woman, wizard. We still have it in those proverb. I married Idia was in, or man Jan Idia. That woman was so diabolic. She was a wizard, powerful wizard. Everyone knows that. That to that Esther, we have it in Proverbs, that there is no wizard like Idia. But someone gave unto her. The one that gave unto her is the snake. The very one here is also propagating. Okay, let me play some video. How she said she returned back as India.
Okay.
These are dead people, okay?
So,
Did you get that?
Okay. Recognition.
Oh, recognition.
Did you get that?
Abba Lawa Professor unto her. That is native daughter, okay? Did you get it? Did you get
that?
Did you get that? Go and fix your womb. In fact, it can never be fixed. In fact, IVF can fix it. A surrogate or surrogation can also fix it. You are mad. Each time I listen to this video, I always turn my stomach. Did you get that? She said, "Idian yes, give a berry." And as you are hearing her voice now, is the voice of the dead. She said she is Idian Yesige, a woman that died, I think, 500 years ago. And she said she is the very that she is that same woman. Rebobobobo he Santa Labo Sendileba. You are being rebuked. Yahweh's mighty name, you the dead. Now, you return back. Rima Santa Labo Sendilebo. You are being rebuked by the finger, ne pierced hand of Yahushua on the cross, and I overcome you by the blood of Yahweh. Yes, in Yahuwah's mighty name. So they do your head out from yourself. Should I still play one more video? So, like this, I pray, and I return it back unto Yuri, unto our womb straight away through the mighty name of Abba Yahuwah. In Yahuwah's mighty name. So, like the people that is castigating these three dead women, she is placing a curse on herself, not them. Because I'm also among of them. That is saying, Father, you are a wicked demon. Listen. Dead people, okay? All right. Oh, no, internet, don't do that. Vanilla, for dead people, like not to shine. This woman provokes me. Alright, now you see. What is she playing? That is why she always full of curses. You see, anyone that is castigating these three dead people, she's placing curse upon them. No, that curse is returned back to Ijuri's bosom in seven ways in Yahweh's mighty name. That's it. So you just heard that from yourself. She is using these three dead people pictures to prayer, excuse me. She's telling her congregation. No, that should be a coven. Yes, she brought witchcraft coven into this world. You know, best known today as an internet gathering. It is a witchcraft coven, okay? She always tell them, go and watch these three dead people pictures. Put it in your chest. Put it under your pillow. Okay. Always make sure you lay with it. And if you want to douche or shower, excuse me, take your bath of that is their spirituality. Two midnights. Always put those three dead people pictures, put it in the water and invoke them upon yourself. And now when you love that message of death, it's like you're gonna eat of the fruit of death. What is that? It is the link of fire. So let's put some more. This is your witchcraft power. The only place who found this out in the royal law that a dead person can subscribe for the living, that you can actually invoke a dead people's spirit, you know, to be communicating. You know, those people, when they just use that devilish, you know, water and the picture to whatever, okay, for themselves, as is whatever, I don't know what they call that, is Sarah or what, yes, they say or what. Now, as soon as that goes to bed, they're going to be seeing snake, you know, flying out of their vagina and their penis. Meanwhile, that snake is coming in. It is a woo. Only place we'll find it is over here. I don't think I'm going to read it and be, you know, using it to expose the Yuri 2 Samuel. No, rather 1 Samuel chapter 20. You can go and read it, the witches of Eden. Okay, how he invoked a dead person from the grave. And when the dead person appeared unto King Saul, And they don't pause in ourselves, because that is not at all Samuel. Because he said, I saw a ghost. It was Samuel a ghost? Prophet Samuel, was he a ghost when he was on earth? No. When he died, he goes right away to the bosom of Father Abraham. He was never a ghost. And when you die, you are not allowed to ascend. Hebrews 9:27 makes it so clear that after death is to face judgment. So when you are mercied or Abiwa, you know, extend his mercy unto you, even though you are feared, therefore, will first of all send it to the bosom of Father Abraham. We see that in Luke chapter 16, 9 to the very end. Okay, now if you are not, that you propagate the message of the dead people right till you goes down to the pit, the bottomless pit, the hell message is propagated unto you. So this demon came from the grave. We don't live in the grave, okay? The grave is not our home. Only Ijori lives in the grave, because Idia is still in the grave unto eternity, and the greatest grave is coming, which is the lake of fire, where all of you will be thrown into Ijori and the 92% of his or her gullible follower. Now only here we'll find a thing like that. When that death spirit appeared unto King Saul, he said, tomorrow you will be with me. Why? Because it is who it was death that appeared unto him. Indeed, tomorrow he was killed. He went to battle, him and his son, not just him only. Him and his son, this is it over here. 1 Samuel 31, 3 to 5 or so. Yeah, 3 to 4. Quickly, let me read this. Tomorrow you will be with me. That is the message. Because the witches of Edom invoked that death spirit, and that death spirit now appeared and now begin to prophesy unto Saul. All right? But he now marks up himself as what? Prophet of Yahuwah. No, the royal law system or governing system doesn't work that way. When you are gone, it's after death, it's to face judgment. We are not allowed to ascend and go in. No. Only in your system we see that. First Samuel, Samuel 31, 3. And the battle went Saul against Saul, and the axe hit him, and he was so wounded of the, or whatever, for. Then said Saul unto his armor bearer, draw thy sword, and thrust me through therewith. Lest this uncircumcised come and thrust me through and abuse me. But his armor bearer would not, for he was so afraid. Therefore, Saul took a sword and fell upon it. Okay, 5. Okay, 6. So Saul died, and his three sons, and his armor bearer, and all his men that same day together. So they do together. Read 28, because that was the prophecy came to come. He said, tomorrow you're going to die. And it was so, because what? Death appeared unto him. The reality took place after two or three chapters. Okay. 29, 30, 31, we saw the death manifest. We also see in Genesis 3, Abiwa said, don't eat that tree. If you try, you shall surely die. And we see the reality manifest took place right away in chapter 4. The spiritual death took place right in Genesis 3, while the physical one took place in Genesis 4. It's always like that. Okay, because when death appears, it's going to be so. All right, I'm reading from the accounts of the book of Yahshua. So this popular royal law we all carry speak different references in different occasions to the book of Yahshua. You can find the references right in Joshua chapter 10 verses 13, 2 Samuel chapter 1 verses 18, 2 Timothy chapter 3 verses 8. So they make references to the book of Yahshua, also quoted from there. So I want to read that very book to you, and this wonderful book. I want to show you where this came from. It came from Babylon. And Babylon is the whole world today. Listen, now the book of Yahshua, chapter 31 or so. Let me be sure. Yeah, 31. I want to read from 40, where they are using dead people power. Yeah, 40. Listen, and Rachel stole her father's images, and she took them, and she concealed them upon the camel upon which she sat. She sat on death. That was why she died. She never came into the Holy Land. All right, now. Because if you love it, you're going to die. You're going to eat of the fruit. And she concealed them upon the camel upon which she sat. And she went on for the one. And this is the manner of the images in Take it. This is he's describing it now. The power they are using, the gods of her father, the one they use in Babylon, the one they worshipped. Listen at 41. And this is the manner of the images in taking a man who is the firstborn and slaying him, and taking the hair of his head, and taking salt, salt and water, okay, and taking salt and salting the head and anointing it. You know, it's also using anointing on here now. It's coming to reality, okay, it's becoming so clear now. And anointing it, then taking a small copper, a tablet of copper, or a tablet of gold, and writing the name upon it. That is representing the picture, this three dead people picture. You see, this woman, D.U. You see? So they will write the name of the dead person upon that tablet. They will be speaking to it. Just as what you already did. This is it. This is the parallel. This is their resemblance. Ribobobobobo, who say Kayabo send the label? Listen, you are a wicked spirit. When Miriados was also making noise, because I always say, you know, when I was searched for all these, you know, tellers of lies, when I said she was a witch confessing, and when I called a video, I make a video against her, I bombarded her. I did about 3 videos first, and she not came, because she knew this one is different. This one don't use the nickel. This one is absolute, another kind. This one is not like hustle. She now begin to ask me to go and delete all my video that I did about her. I said, Mary, you are just a small demon. Get out of my sight. If you trouble me more, I will do another one. She keep making it. Then I do another one. After I've done that, I say, come over. Come and listen again. I bombard you again. She never replied me. The very first day she saw me blasting the jury, she was the one to help me to share the video. I said, Beredos, you are a small demon. Yuri is a high-ranking demon. Yuri is prophetic. Please, don't just distract me. You just go your way, okay? Even though you still talk about that, I will not make no more video because I don't have your time. You are just a small demon. Yuri is a high, also a Yuri. And let me deal with her. Don't distract me. Now listen. And this is the manner of the images in taking a man who is the firstborn and slay him, and taking the hair of his head, and taking salt and salting the head and anointing it in oil, then taking a small tablet of copper or a tablet of gold and writing the name upon it and placing the tablet under his tongue. Where is life and death? It's in the tongue. And taking the head with the tablet under the tongue and putting it in the house. You're gonna put all in the house and lighting up light before it and bow down to it. You're just praying through it. That is how you bow down. You worship holy deity. You worship dead people. 42. And at that time, when they bow down to it, it speaketh to them. Listen now, when they use the picture of Idia, Emotan, Iden, to shower, to bathe themselves, what happened? As soon as they lay their head, you're going to be seeing there's going to be ministering. Let me tell you, don't be deceived. Idia is in the bottomless pit. So do Eden. Eden, you don't have the right. You never created your life. That one is severe. You don't have the right to take your life. That one killed herself by asking them to use her for sacrifice. Ijore says, Zesen Tedo, Igabujore. Heaven knows the way I hate that woman. Ah, no. Heaven knows. Ah, Yimayore Zero Utagbona. Ah, no. 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 Very wicked spirit. Oh, what that? She died for Bini. Oh, Afnyawu. What would I mean? Idea is in pain. Mota is in pain. What did they call the other one? They are all in pain. They are in the bottomless pit because they never serve Yehovah. They were pagan, wicked spirit. Used them. Worshiping fallen deities. After death is to feel judgment. Whatever you sow, that is what you will reap. You can't start sowing wood. After you are dead, you will be said, you're going to ascend to heaven. You are in the pit. Now listen. You saw the picture. They will head. The supposed sword is going to be ministering unto them. But this not baffles your mind. As soon as they use your recipe for spirituality, when they put the idea is going to be ministering. They're going to be see a motor. Ah, blessing them. Through the power. Okay, quickly, let me rush. And at that time, when they bow to it, he speaketh to them in all matters. What are you saying? that they ask of it through the power of the name which is written in it. 3, and the same make them, and some make them in the figures of a man. This is the image of figure of an ideal back of the beast. That is the image. Abba Yahweh warned us never to bow down to any craven image. You are breaking our commandment heavily. Break your neck. Yes. Listen. Image the figures of men and of gold and silver and go to them in times, not to them. And the figures receive the influence of the stars. Yore said she is a moon. Before she was said she was a star. And tell the future things. And in this manner were the images which were cast from her father had hung it over there. So what is the art of seat? When she took these images, she sat on them. So what happened? Revelation 17, we see a woman sat upon water. Revelation 17, when a woman sat upon water. Revelation 17, 15, we now see that people, water was a people. So what is the art of seat? Daniel chapter 9, verses 3, it said this king, when he comes, he's gonna stand and rule. Seat means authority to rule over people. Relaxing. You don't see her, she sat relaxing. All of them looking up to her. In the same manner with standing, it means authority to rule. You see, it said this woman, Raquel, best known as Rachel, sit upon this folly deity. And that was what Abba Yahweh killed her in the wilderness. That was why she couldn't make it at all to the promised land. She died on the way. You've been with a powerful man of Yahweh. Are you still believing all this crap? Dead people, you took it away and speak it to them. She died. Exactly what Yuri is proclaiming unto you. If you love it, you're going to be eating of the fruit of death. Okay, like I said, I don't want to do too. I just don't want to put this my own part. My own part is so simple. I've been doing it. I'm the wife of Yahushua. So lovely, okay? I'll be using it to priest because that is who I am. Listen now. Joke apart. In fact, I'm not joking. I'm very serious. Proverbs. This should have been my own part, but I want to call it and be making some talking upon it, okay? How special woman is, okay? Woman is to help the man. Just as the ministry is helping Abba Yahweh, and you're the ministry of dead people, is also helping dead people. That was why Yahushua said, let the dead bury their own dead. Indeed, India is burying her own dead. Listen now, Proverbs 18, 22, it says, when a man finds a wife, you find a good thing, all right? Because in her, your mission is going to be accomplished in like manner the folly deities. Now, Luke chapter 1, 26 to 35, even Abba Yahweh also seeking help from a woman, called Mariam. The mother of our Messiah. He goes to her. Come on, give me your womb. I want to put in my word. He like one of the folly deity goes to the first woman. Come on, give me your womb. I want to put my seed in. That was what Abba Yahweh said. I'm going to put enmity between you and the woman, between your seed and her seed. Only woman can provide that. Man cannot give pregnancy to himself. No woman does that. Abba Yahweh also came to seek this kind of help in us. Now, John 7, 37 to 38, I think I'm going to be reading it. Let me see if there is time. Because the vision is in our womb. It's in our belly. That is why we can pour it out. John 7, 37. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Yahushua still then cried, saying, if any man taste, let him come unto me and drink. 38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall overflow rivers of living water. Which one is overflowing from the belly of urina? Or who will not rot death? One would. Now, Matthew 7, okay, 21 to 23, it said that the man is going to say, we prophesy, we cast a demon, we do many wonders in your name. And the Messiah will say, I never knew you. So what is to knew you? Genesis 4, 1, it said, Adam knew his wife planting seed. So Yahushua said, I never knew you like that kind of a husband and wife. So I didn't put no water in your belly. Someone does that to you. That is the folly deity. It's our womb. We carry the mission. We carry the vision. Our womb is the laboratory of Abba Yahweh, the very one the serpent is also using in that of Yuri. Which any man or woman that also goes to her, the devil is using their womb, their belly. That's where they store all those nonsense. That's how you see them see vision, because it came from the womb. It's been dropped over there for you to carry. Now, the earth, what is it being called in the holy language? It's being called Adama. So what is Adama? It simply means Adam came from a young woman. In fact, the earth is a woman. In the book of Hanukkah, I also see over there that the water on earth is being called feminist, while the water above is being called masculine. It is always like that. Women always have a huge part to play in the life of a man, in likewise the ministry of Abeyewa. Quickly, let me play it. There's never no way. Let me read here, excuse me. There's never no way Abeyewa left out a woman. No, we include us. John chapter 20 is about this matter. The message of resurrection, the very one I'm giving unto you. If you love it, you will be having eternal life. I read now 15. And Yahushua saith unto her, woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, sir, if thou have bought him, tell me where thou hast led him, and I will take him away. We don't seek the living among the dead. But you're seeking the living. You're seeking the dead people for the living. Eh? 16. Yahushua saith unto her, Mariam. And she told herself, and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, master, not master, which is to say, great one. Now listen, 17. Yahushua saith unto her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my father, but go to my brethren, and say unto them, I ascend unto my father, and your father, and to my Elohim, and your Elohim. And Maria Magdala came and told the disciples, and she that she had seen the risen Adonai, and that he had spoken these things unto her. And right away, Yahushua confirms that in the evening. This is the message of, that is where the ministry started. That is where we begin to say, hey, our king is risen, our king is risen. We now begin to pass the message of resurrection. According to the history, Maria was being called apostle to the apostles. She is the overall. Because woman need to play that. When Messiah was going to the cross, she played a huge part. She anointed him. She played the part of the high priest. And when he also raised, he also gave her that message of resurrection. The very one we are propagating unto you today. This is the same woman in anticipation. It is the wife of Yahushua. Okay. Now, when you go to Proverbs chapter 31, let me be sure. Yes, Proverbs 31, reading from 10 to 31. That is the wife of Yahushua HaMashiach in anticipation. Now, Revelation 21, we see Abeyewa also liking the new earth as a bride. Okay. Adorned for her husband. So woman have a huge part to play. That is the restoration to the fallen kingdom. Israel, you have been rebuked, and I'm still coming back for you. Yahweh's mighty name. I'm not done at all until you enter the grave. Yes, in Yahweh's mighty name. All right, now family, we want to talk about Izeyamu, snake pastor Izeyamu. That will be tomorrow, okay? A pastor that is imam, is a politician, is a pastor. This we don't find in the royal law. You can't blend the both together. The Caesar needs to go away, while the ministry needs to remain on its own. But they are blending it together. So we'll do that briefly tomorrow. Before we now talk about the lunar Shabbat, the scripture there misquoted and translated, that they are very one they are using to deceive people. You know, that's what we are doing in this very platform. Expose, to expose the hiding place of sin.